Kraft Philadelphia. Pure white, creamy tasting cheese. We added nothing, so you can add just what you like. We added nothing, so you can add what you like to Kraft Philadelphia. What do you like?
Have you noticed that people who drink gin with tonic, whiskey with ginger ale, brandy with soda, find it easy to mix? While people who drink vodka don't. That's why Canada Dry have perfected Vostok. Vostok is a new, slightly pink, lightly aromatic mixer made to go with vodka. Vostok, made to help vodka drinkers mix.
Do you know the one word recipe for cheesecake? Sweet crumbly biscuit, smooth tangy filling. Just add milk and butter, made in 10 minutes and no baking. Greens, the one word recipe for cheesecake. Greens cheesecake.
Now that's Barry Sheen on number 7. He's a man to watch here. Look at him go. Whoops, God. Now you know why he's been world champion 2 years running.
Well done, Barry.
Yeah. What a way to learn a living.
Oh, it's got its brighter side, you know.
It's all right for some.
Of course, I altered my Brute 33.
Go on, Steph. Splash it all over.
Nothing beats the great smell of Brute.
Put quality products together with low prices in a really exciting competition, and what do you get?
The Quality to Value Competition!
They're right. Look at the quality products on this Wheel of Value. Buy any one of those at your local chemist where you see the Point to Value sign, and you could win a Chrysler Sunbeam, plus lots of other super prizes. Get your entry form from your local chemist only where you see this sign, and if you win first prize, I'll deliver it. You give me a lift home, won't you?
Fascinating. There's something you've probably only seen pictures of. A wild flower.
This summer, the Sunday Times invites you to get to know Britain better.
An actual piece of the River Thames.
Shows you the countryside as you've never seen it before.
Remaining sections of Ben Nevis.
Helps you get more out of summer.
A tree. And the pride of the exhibition, grass.
And what's that?
Well, we're not quite sure. But it was found all over the British countryside.
Enjoy it while it's still there.
This driver could have got 35 miles to the gallon. Pity he only got 25. Could it be the heavy-footed way he was driving? Every night he drives home this way, and every night he's the fastest man from one jam to the next. Doesn't he know that by driving at 70 rather than at 50, he's using over a third more petrol? All that petrol just so he can sit and wait at the next roundabout. What a waste. Step off.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for
I designed this can for Unipart. But they wanted you to know that their antifreeze is anti-rust and will protect your engine from corrosion. And then that it's anti-boil and it won't evaporate away and leave your engine unprotected. And then that it's safe for all engines. You see the problem. So, if we just call it Unipart Universal Antifreeze, you'll remember the rest, won't you?
Thousands of parts for millions of cars. Unipart.
For the next 6 weeks, the Sunday Times magazine celebrates beauty. We look at what people have done to make themselves beautiful and show how the concept of beauty changes from decade to decade. see how the beautiful people over the ages have tried to make themselves absolutely beautiful.
62 pints of ass's milk, please, George.
Cats know a thing or two. They know the warmest place. They know all the shortcuts. And they always know when it's dinner time. Because dinner time means kitty cat. Fish and liver today. Cats love kitty cat. It's as if they know it's good for them. That special balance of protein, calcium, and vitamins. Kitty cat. Cats know it's good for them.
Some things in life work better than others. Grundig, probably the best name on a colour television.
Hands up all those who have found lumps of fat or gristle in a meat pie filling. Right, let me introduce you to Yeoman, the original pie filling guaranteed to have no lumps of fat or gristle. Yeoman is tasty beef, made into firm pieces that taste as good as they look. If you ever find a lump of fat or gristle in Yeoman, they'll give you your money back. Guaranteed.
This Thursday night on Thames, two-way entertainment for late-night viewing.
At 10:30, this sporting land looks at tennis, at the game and the players.
It's a very tough world these days. It's not really a pleasure, although if I went back in those 9 years, I'd still do exactly the same.
We look at tennis from its early beginnings to the present big game business in this sporting land at 10:30.
Then at 11, medical examiner Quincy arrives on the scene to investigate the mysterious death of a priest in suspicious surroundings.
I want them to tell you that Father Terrell's body was planted with that girl.
Think that Father Terrell died in this office and that I moved the body to that girl's apartment to discredit him.
Where did it all happen? Nobody can tell me but you.
This sporting land looks at tennis at 10:30.
And Quincy looks out for a killer at 11.
A double helping of late night entertainment this Thursday night on Thames.
Duncan.
620 Mark, bitte.
You take American Express?
But of course, sir.
Only first class available on that flight, sir. That's £57 extra. American Express? That's fine, sir.
The American Express card says more about you than cash ever can. I recommend you apply now.
Ring 01-388-1111 now for your application form.
Mmm, delicious. Rosie's lime marmalade. Why haven't we had this before? Mmm. This isn't number 8, is it?
Number 12.
We'd better be going. You mind if I take my toast?
Get up to something different with Rosie's lime marmalade.
Makes real freedom possible. Come on in.
Headache? I don't have time for a headache. If I do, I try to get rid of it. Especially if it's a migraine headache. Me? I take Aspro Clear. They dissolve faster in the glass than tablets do in the stomach.
Tests show that AspoClear dissolves in the glass three times faster than most ordinary pain relief tablets do in the stomach.
Tastes pleasanter too.
New AspoClear goes clear to the pain. Helps relieve migraine headache too.
TV Times is more than a guide to ITV programmes. It brings you an intimate view of the stars you'll be seeing on your screens. There's sexy Robert Redford giving a rare interview about home and family life on his own private mountain. Bouncy Tommy Steele telling of 3 hours that changed his life. Booming Peggy Mount on the night they really did find a man beneath her bed. And meet the men beneath the Muppets.
I never knew there was so much in it.
There's something for everyone in TV Times this week.
This Friday at 7:30, step into the world of Pam Ayres.
You've hurt his feelings now. He understands every word you say.
Does he?
Yes.
Push off!
Some folks think I'm crazy, yes, crazy over you. I'm coming back as a cardboard box, but a letter card won't do. Ho! Next time I'm coming back as a cardboard box and get myself delivered to you in time for Christmas.
Join Pam Ayres and her guests this Friday at 7:30 on ITV.
And get myself delivered to you.
You know how much dogs love fresh meat. Well, here's something pretty amazing. New Hap. Moist, meaty, really juicy chunks that look and taste as good as fresh meat. Dogs love it just as much. See, one collie's eating fresh meat, the other Hap. Now watch. You can even change the bowls over and the dogs love it just the same. Give your dog New Hap. It looks and tastes as good as fresh meat.
A pure and simple thing like rain means a lot to flowers. And this new Pure and Simple will mean a lot to your skin. New Pure and Simple is light and easily absorbed. It simply adds moisture to your skin, bringing it a smoothness and a softness that really lasts. New Pure and Simple in both a lotion and cream for softness that really lasts.
In 1975, Tusker Rock Lighthouse was painted in Santex to protect it against anything the weather could throw at it. Santex. There's no better protection for your home.
Mr. Rawlings, Your Majesty.
Her Majesty, Mr. Rawlings.
Oh, Your Majesty.
Mr. Rawlings, we find your tonic water most refreshing. And we have today ordered another bottle.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
We are intrigued, Mr. Rawlings, as to why it is called Indian tonic water.
Tandoori, why do we call it Indian tonic water?
Why not?
I regret, ma'am, that of necessity that must remain a trade secret. She was not amused.
Rawlings, we knew how. Before,
you know who.
Sooner or later, your car will get a dent or a hole. So, what do you do? If you're wise, you'll use Contour, the sensational new filler paste from Holtz. It's easy to mix, easy to apply, and easy to sand into shape. You get an ultra-smooth finish, better results, Contour's permanent, and very useful around the home, too, for repairing drain pipes, filling garage doors, mending windowsills, fixing... Why not try Contour yourself? Or else...
You can do it with Holtz.
Do you know the one-word recipe for cheesecake? Sweet crumbly biscuit, smooth tangy filling. Just add milk and butter, made in 10 minutes and no baking. Greens, the one-word recipe for cheesecake.
Greens cheesecake.
Hello, sir.
Oh, no, sir. Nothing tastes nicer than Cadbury's Dairy Milk.
Top.
Lovely, isn't it? Mm. And as anyone can see, every bar is chunky.
Magic.
Yeah. That's because there's a glass and a half of full cream milk in every half pound. That's why, sir, nothing tastes nicer than Cadbury's Dairy Milk. Than Cadbury's Dairy Milk!
And the main
In points again. The miners' leader, Mr. Gormley, has told the government to stay out of wage negotiations and get on with their own job. The Egyptian and Israeli foreign ministers will meet in London later this month in another effort to get things moving towards a Middle East peace settlement. The Archbishop of York has defended Prince Charles's comments on that disagreements on church doctrine cause people needless distress. Sue Barker is out of Wimbledon. Virginia Wade is through. Mike Brearley got a duck in the test. And that's the news so far this evening from me. Goodbye.
Tonight, World in Action presents the disturbing results of a six-month investigation into Britain's extreme right-wing party, the National Front. Party workers, infiltrators, defectors, and victims tell of brutality and deception. A file of confidential documents, never before seen in public, shows that behind the party's respectable public face are the secret Nazis. That's World in Action, the National Front, tonight, 8:30.
Now the Thames area weather forecast for tonight and tomorrow Tuesday. It'll be cloudy and windy tonight with some heavy showers. Minimum temperature 8 degrees centigrade. Tomorrow will be a cool, mostly cloudy day with only a little sunshine. Showers are likely then too, and some of them will be heavy. Winds will be fresh northwesterly, and the maximum temperature tomorrow will be 15 degrees centigrade. That's very cool for early July, so not an attractive prospect. Today's pollen count was 7, which is very low. That's the weather forecast. Next, it's Thames at 6.
Hello, this is Thames at 6, and in tonight's programme, we'll be doing it our way, which is very different from the way that Nicky Horn discovered Sid Vicious doing it.
Oh, no!
We'll be finding out why these people are celebrating down at the sewage works in their best frocks and returning to the battle of Bethnal Green Hospital. But first, news of three murder inquiries in Essex. The latest concerns the death of a 21-year-old Guyanese nurse whose body was found last night concealed in an underground shaft at Claybury Mental Hospital at Woodford Bridge. Bob Southgate has the details.
The body of the nurse, Miss Sumitra Shiram, was found by three 16-year-old boys who were playing in the hospital grounds. They lifted up a manhole cover and saw the body in a shaft about 10 feet below. Miss Shiram worked at Whips Cross Hospital, 4 miles away in Leytonstone, and had been missing for a fortnight. Her hands had been tied behind her back with a blouse, which was all she was wearing when she was found. She'd been strangled. Police say that a 25-year-old man is helping them with their inquiries. Meanwhile, police investigating the death of 53-year-old Mrs. Vera Bullock, who was found tied up and suffocated at her home in Chadwell St. Mary last Friday, are examining a theory that she was killed by her nephew, 29-year-old Raymond Briggs, who then committed suicide. Mr. Briggs was found hanged in a copse at nearby Terrell's Heath on Saturday morning. A spokesman at the murder room at Tilbury Police Station told me this afternoon, "We can't rule out a link between the two deaths." Police are looking for anyone who saw Mrs. Bullock on Thursday or Mr. Briggs on Friday. Mr. Briggs, who walked with a limp, used to exercise his dogs on Terrell's Heath most days. And in Woodford, police have issued a photo-fit picture of a man they want to interview in connection with the murder of a part-time barman at the Rising Sun Public House last Sunday night. The man's described as aged between 25 and 30, 5'6" tall, with blonde hair. He was wearing a grey roll-neck sweater and black jacket and was seen shortly after the murder in an orange crash helmet. He's described as slim, and he would have needed to be since he made his escape head-first through a leaded light window in the front lounge of the pub.
This morning, the papers were calling it the biggest clash between the royalty and the church for 40 years, it being Prince Charles's remarks to a Salvation Army meeting in which he criticised those aspects of religious doctrine which, in his words, cause unnecessary distress. Was the prince referring to the wedding difficulties of his cousin, Prince Michael of Kent, or was he worried about his own future? Is Charles in love with a Catholic, queried the Sun, as perhaps only it could. Does it all matter anyway? With me is a leading Roman Catholic layman and staunch monarchist, Norman St. John Stevens MP. Norman St. John Stevens, do you think Prince Charles was referring specifically to the marriage of his cousin when he made those remarks?
I would think it unlikely. It may have been somewhere in the back of his mind, but it would be very unusual for a member of the royal family on such a public occasion to refer to a family difficulty in that way. I see the people have taken it like that. I rather doubt whether he was referring to it.
Was then he expressing the misgivings of thousands of people?
He may have expressed what is in people's minds, certainly, about this, because I think a lot of people feel very sad and disappointed that a couple like this haven't been able to have a marriage in church. They can't be married in the Church of England, they can't be married in the Roman Catholic Church, and they've had to put up with the second best in a register office. And I think many people have sympathy with them. They feel they've been caught up in a kind of ecclesiastical dispute, and they've been the ones who've suffered.
Couldn't the Pope have made an exception in their case and allowed them to marry in church? After all, the Baroness is a staunch Catholic.
Yes, the Pope could have made an exception, but I think it would have been very invidious for him to make an exception for a royal couple, because after all, the rules are for everyone. The rules are there, and the rules say, this is the rules of the Roman Catholic Church, that the Roman Catholic partner has to make a promise to do all that's possible to bring up the children in the Catholic faith. And clearly, from the words of the Baroness, from the words of the Prince, it was impossible for that condition to be fulfilled. And so I would pass on to the next stage. I would say within the parameters of the existing rules, I think the Pope was probably right to take the decision he did. But then I asked myself, are these rules right? And I think if two people of different faiths get together in marriage, they've created an ecumenical situation, they've created a relationship between two churches, they're responsible for the upbringing of the children, and it should be their decision, free from any pressure from any church, as to how they decide the children should be brought up.
Would you have counted as pressure the Vatican official who said that he regarded Prince Charles's remarks as a bit of a cheek? Isn't that a bit strong?
I think it's a bit of a cheek for a Vatican official, an anonymous being, to speak out in that way. After all, the people who should speak are the heads of the congregation.
BBC Two's William Wyler season of films continues in a little over 10 minutes with The Little Foxes, starring Betty Davis and Herbert Marshall. Here on BBC One now, Parkinson.
Evening and welcome. George
A springtime illusion. The bottle said roses, and you can't have green roses, or so one supposes. So what were we drinking, so cool and so bright? That freshness, that greenness which dazzled our sight. We debated at length, then agreed it was lime. And as for the drinking of roses, sublime.
Ah, John.
It's James, sir.
No doubt it is, yes.
Hunt, sir.
I can see that, sir. Now, as Texaco's number one driver, your life is going to be one round of press conferences, chat shows, parties, and all that kind of thing. There's one thing you must remember. Anybody asks you about Texaco, Haviland, I want you to tell them...
You can't buy a better motor oil, sir.
What?
You can't buy a better motor oil than Texaco, Haviland, sir.
Oh, good, very good. You know, I'm beginning to like you. You're showing great promise. You really, you've played your cards right. You could go a long way in this business. You really could. What was the name again?
James, sir.
Know the name of the ruddy oil, you jittery idiot.
Texaco Haviland. You can't buy a better motor oil.
What was it that made this country great? Queuing. Queuing to pay the rates, the electricity, and the gas.
There's a back to this queue, you know.
queuing to pay the HP and the phone bill. It teaches us tolerance, patience, and courtesy. The British sense of fair play.
Excuse me. You've lost your place, haven't you, sir?
What do you think he is?
It breeds in us fortitude against the occasional setback.
No. Down the corridor, third door on the left.
Of course, if you open an account at Barclays Bank, and it only takes about 5 minutes to arrange, you'll have to queue sometimes. But you'll never need to queue to pay a bill again.
Swing ball from Dunlop. A great ball game that's swinging everywhere. Play it to win. Play it for fun. For any time, for anyone. Everyone's swing ball.
Now, L'Oreal have created L-Serve Balsam, a beautiful new after-shampoo cream conditioning rinse. They call it the cream of cream rinses. Comb it through after you shampoo and see how it leaves your hair soft, shiny, and so manageable. Beautiful new L-Serve Balsam cream conditioning rinse, exclusively from L'Oreal. Because you're worth it.
EMI bring you the best of the best of the Beach Boys.
It's automatic when I talk to gold when the conversation turns to girls we knew.
Well, since she put me down, I've been up to it in my head. I come in late at night. I wish they all could be Californian. We wish they all could be Californian.
And she'll have fun, fun, fun too.
The Beach Boys, 20 golden greats, 20 tracks for $2.99.
Tuesday night at 6:50, the $6 million man returns to face another dangerous assignment. $6 Million Man is back next Tuesday night at 6:50. But in a moment tonight, Armchair Thriller.
Hello, I'm Katie Holland. I've been testing the Electrolux 502 cleaner. Look how the cleaning head adjusts itself for carpets and hard floors. And it cleans right up to the skirting board. They tell me it's these side suction channels that do it. And the hose plugs straight in for all over cleaning. No messy dust bag emptying either. It lifts clean out. I've used other cleaners, but I've never found one with so many good things as the Electrolux 502. It really does clean better, faster.
For me, martini is a flavor that lingers in the mind forever. Martini is the taste of unfamiliar places you seem to have known for always. Martini is a flavor, a sensation, a taste. Martini is unmistakable. Martini is.
Whatever you want, get it today. Green Shield New Deal.
Everything in the New Deal catalog is now available from Argos stores at a big discount, so you save money on everything.
Green Shield New Deal.
Now with one full saver book, you can get what you want simply by paying the difference in cash. With enough books, you can get it free.
Whatever you want, get it today. Green Shield.
See this rubber heel mark? It's hard to clean off an unshined floor, but on a clear shine, easy. That's because dirt simply slides off a clear shine. Clear floor shine makes your floor easier to clean.
This week's TV Times is 96 pages of holiday entertainment for the whole family. Heading the Easter parade are those teenage bombshells Lena and Bonnie. Then Tommy Steele tells what makes TV magic for him. Find out who said Glynis Johns was mad and take a ringside seat with David Hamilton. You could also win a deposit on a new house. Collect a half-prize outing to a National Trust property.
I never knew there was so much in it.
There's even a portrait of Bodie from The Professionals. So see why 11 million people will enjoy TV Times over Easter.